The other thing that is key, plants. Plants, 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 and plants. I love this chair because it is so freaking comfortable. Like, you don't even understand. It's like the perfect size for, just adjust this because you know I have to be adjusting. It's the perfect size for a bedroom chair, you know, and it's, like I said, it is very, it's very comfortable. And bonus, it swivels, which is like kind of, I love a swivel chair, you know, that means you don't have to move it, and it kind of rocks. So this, I don't know where my dad got this chair, which is interesting. I feel like we could totally have an interior decorating business because he buys this stuff that, like, at first glance you're like, that's stupid, but then it actually has so many qualities about it that makes it worthwhile that you're just like, oh, I can totally incorporate it. So one of these days I want to actually get it reupholstered, and I think I'm going to show you an example of who I would love to have the fabric to reupholster it. This pillow came with like a king. This has a king bed, and it came with a set. Like, my dad had this set, and this was one of the pillows. So I just put that pillow there. I have to readjust this. I have to center this. But these are just, I just got shadow boxes. I know that they weren't expensive, and these are just like foliage or something from Dominica. I have a friend, Annalisa Jensen, who lives in Dominica, and I got these from there, and I just thought they looked really cool. And so now, let's see if I can get a good shot of them. Now they're on the wall, so they're gonna be like this and this when I get an opportunity. So there's that. So that's one thing I already had, didn't need to buy anything. The throw already had, the books. I feel like it's important for me to communicate who I am to my guests, because I want them to, well, one, know what they're working with, and know that I come from a particular cultural space that I'm really proud of. And so don't get it twisted. Don't say nothing funny or foolish. So I'm gonna give you some clues. I'm gonna give you some luck clues. So much about running an Airbnb is communicating to your guests without telling them directly, because you don't know these people. You know, you don't know who they, I mean, I'm fortunate that I've had a lot of regulars, but who knows if they're gonna come back after, you know. So I have to tell them things about how I want my house to be run without telling them, because that sounds like you're like being a parent or something, or like trying to tell them what to do. And I'm not. Well, that's not true. I am trying to tell them what to do, but I want them to feel good about it. I don't want them to feel like I am disrespecting their adulthood, because they're all adults that come. You know, I don't have, my house isn't a kid house. One day I would like to like get, you know, a house that is totally equipped for people with young children and all that kind of stuff. But that's gonna be a whole house, because I'm not gonna like be, I love kids, but I got work to do. I have to communicate to them what I want without, I found that putting those little details helps me, one, create a point of conversation with my guests, which is always helpful when you have conversation with them. When you live with them, when you live in the same property, it always makes for a better experience on both sides, really, because you end up like learning something cool, and they feel more apt to give you a good review, especially if everything else is in order as well. This little lamp I already had, I got it from Lowe's. I think it was maybe $16. I had that. Now I'm about to hit y'all to some pimp game. This right here, I need a little lamp. Now, I would prefer a floor lamp. I would, or would I? I don't know at this point now that I have this set up, but I would like to explore maybe a different kind of lamp. I don't know. But for right now, because the effect of the lamp is so, it just like makes that little nook pop. I knew I wanted a lamp there, but none of my tables, the tables that I had access to, because remember, I'm not spending any money, none of the tables that I had access to were the right size, that you could still swivel, that it would be, you know, kind of intimate and nice. So I had to figure something out. This is a hamper that I just turned upside down. So, you know, ultimately, I want to still use that as a table, but now that's a hack that I can use. If I see like a hamper or something that I like that's woven like that, I can use it. And right now I probably am going to like make a base for it and also get a piece of plexiglass cut in a circle or something like that. There's so many things you could get. You could get a cutting board, you could get a marble platter, you could get so many things that would fit into that, like really fill this whole circle. So I'm gonna make sure that I get the dimensions of this, because you never know, you might find it somewhere. So I loved that. Now I already had the idea for the whatever that stuff is from Dominica, but I was like, I feel like I want to put something on this wall, because when you're sitting down, you know, you're creating a little vista. I don't know if you see that. Do you see the vista? Do you see the little scene? So I was like, I want to put something like in this area. So what I plan on doing is taking the top, oh yes, the top from the hamper and putting it here. And if you look on the wall, in the mirror, it really looks nice. It looks nice. You know, I'm going to play around, but I'm like, that's perfect. That's just a little object that I can do. And I was able to utilize both elements of this in a really, I think, clever way. So we'll just do the bathroom really quick. So this is the bathroom. Nothing too crazy. I always set up washtub cloths and towels for my guests, and a face or a hand towel rather. There's a little a hook that they can put on. They can actually put the hand towel on. I also recommend putting a clock in the bathroom, because oftentimes, you know, when you're in the bathroom, you may have your phone, but you may not. And so a little battery operated clock, just to kind of remind people, because they're usually like getting ready to go somewhere. I mean, remember, these people are typically traveling, they have things to do. And so to have a little clock there helps. This is, again, I don't know, but it's like these little metal leaves that are really sharp. So I knew I had to put them someplace that, you know, would give me the effect in terms of display, but that wasn't gonna like cut anybody or whatever. So that turned out really well. This, I don't know. I feel like I'm gonna find a place for this and this, but for right now, I just combine them. But I love this little bowl, because we are in the time that we are. I am making sure that I only have two toiletries, because I hate to say it like that, but I don't know these people. They might get to taking a toilet tissue, and if they do, I like when they leave or whatever, then I'll only be out of one instead of like a whole package. Is that ratchet? Anyway, I rearranged this, so I had a lot more storage space. I am letting y'all see all my innards. So I have a lot of storage space on this side, so I'm gonna figure out what I wanna do with this, because I know that there's a way I can utilize that better. But this is all nice and clean and ready for my guest, and I think his girlfriend is gonna come, you know, some of the times or whatever. This right here is kind of like where the magic happened, because this bed was facing out this way, it just made the room really dark because this is, and I actually want, I mean, and it's okay that it's dark, but you gotta like break it up a little bit because this was attached to that. And ultimately I want to refinish and paint this like maybe in a, because this is some good ass furniture. This furniture is definitely older than I am. Just switching out the pulls, y'all, that thing is gonna be popping. Oh, another thing that I would very much suggest to you is duvet covers for your Airbnb guests, because you can launder duvet covers along with, like, that doesn't have to be the only thing in your washer. So you can have more, you know, you can just flip the room really quickly, and you've got these fresh duvet covers. The other thing that I did, there wasn't a TV in here, so you could tell this all goes with the same set. I got some paper and a little pen if people want to do that. I also put a, like, you know, I'm seeing how, again, I already had this. I got this from Home Goods or something. You know, I figure you definitely need to have a tray in your rooms, just because people, even if you told somebody, that you can't eat in the room, they're probably gonna eat in the room. So what you wanna do is minimize the accidents in terms of spillage or whatever. And if they have a tray, that's much more easy to manage. So I'm probably gonna get like another, I may get another tray, I may not. I like the way this whole diamond stripe. It's funny because we're human beings, so we're always looking for patterns. And so to be able to just notice the through line and just use what you have has been tremendously satisfying to me. And I feel like I've upgraded the room with no cost to me. And I'm gonna charge probably about $8 more per night when I put it up again on the website. So I'm thrilled about that. The other thing that is key, plants. The thing about plants is that, see, this is another situation. You can share that, oh yeah, I got these plants, and maybe it gives you an opportunity to, especially if somebody's gonna be in the house for a period of time, you wanna pop into that room, because sometimes people will do something to your room and not tell you about it. And it's not a big deal. Like, it doesn't cost a lot. But
if you don't, like, get it before, it's like all this rigmarole of getting, you know, it's a whole thing. I had a guest that broke one of the blades, and you'll see after we replace all the blades from the receiving hall. See what's there. And he didn't tell me. You know what I mean? I just so happened to be in there. There was some reason why I was in there. I was getting something out of the, like, closet or whatever, and I noticed it. And so I was like, okay, this is why you gotta come again.
Plants, in addition to, I try to put some snake plants in all of the bedrooms because they're supposed to give you good oxygen at night. But in addition to them being like just amazing living things to be around, they give you a really good excuse to pop into the room because you gotta water them or you gotta do something. And that's a way without saying, like, it's like a very like nice and gentle way of communicating that, again, this is my house. I have something that's living inside your room. I'm responsible for it. I like to take care of it. So you'll have to forgive me if I pop in every once in a while. Like I said, especially if they're staying for a long period of time, to take care of them, you know? Like, I don't want you to have to worry about that. I'll do it. You see how that worked? This painting was actually in the room that I'm not gonna be renting out because I'm gonna be living there. And so it kinda just, like I said, it just, before you know it, you got a theme going. You got a theme going that you can kind of like connect to. Yeah, so I'm gonna put that on this wall when I find my tape measure, kind of a little bit above my hips, so if somebody wants to go on the other side of the bed, which they really don't need to, but if there is a space, like, this is one of my pet peeves, when they put the bed flush to the side and you can't make that thing up, that really gets my goat. So I always do that, just enough, you know. It doesn't have to be too much, but you know, you see I'm in there. I'm gonna make sure that it's high enough so if somebody bumps their booty, you know, they're not gonna disturb the painting in any way. The other part that I am really, oh, and I want, so the, remember when I was telling you about I want to reupholster that chair? I want to reupholster with not this particular print, but there is an amazing designer who happens to be a friend of mine, Rochelle Porter. I'll make sure I get her information in the description and pop in some shit or whatever, because she is amazing. She's been, it's all like fair trade, organic, like this, you know, she's a black woman. It's great quality. I've probably had this, I can't remember how long I've had this, but I've had this for some years, and it just, I feel like it just adds like such a nice little pop to this space. So I'm probably always gonna do, like, I think if I don't do something with a pattern, it's likely that I'll get like some like white duvet covers or gray or, you know, something really neutral, because with the white, the thing about the white is that you can bleach that thing. It's just about like, okay, how do I maintain not only, you know, the appearance, but how do I make this as easy for myself to keep sanitary? You know, I have the Lysol, I have the Clorox wipes. I always had that. So, you know, even when the quarantine hit, I had all of those materials, which I really commend my dad for just always being a far range thinker about this kind of stuff, but that's a whole nother topic. But what I like about the fact that I can anchor it with these two, because they were attached, dark pieces, is that you have all of this light to really brighten the room, to really lift it. So even if I paint the walls, I don't know, I definitely want to paint the walls. I don't know what color. I'm gonna actually consult with Providence Life Design. Again, I'll put all the details and just get her feedback. I think she'll be impressed with how I change this, honestly. And then this was the mirror on top of the bureau. And so I just turned it into a headboard. Again, it's like there's so many mirrors. Having another one just makes a lot of sense, because I was like, well, what am I gonna do? Am I gonna store it? It's like, no, you should just make it into the headboard. Oh, and then this, so I got an email from Airbnb, and they were like, yeah, people are wanting to stay longer. And so I'm like, okay, if people wanna stay longer, they're gonna wanna have closet space. So I took out all the boxes and everything that I had for storage, with the exception of the suitcase, because come on, give me something. I cleared this for my guests to be able to use. I think this is gonna change like how people use this room too, because it's now it doesn't just seem like a place where you sleep, it's a place where you can relax. It's gonna automatically, and I'm pretty certain about this, it's gonna automatically make them treat the room nicer. You know, they're gonna want to replicate, like, instead of just having like stuff everywhere, they're gonna want to keep this area, I think, free of debris so they can look out there and all that kind of stuff, and they can put their stuff, there's enough room now for them to put their stuff in the closet. The other thing about your Airbnb is that you want to keep all the things that you need to turn the room, you want it to be in close proximity. When I was, it's so crazy, when I was a housekeeper for Courtyard by Marriott, we had a cart that had everything on it. So you didn't have to go anywhere. Like, most houses have a linen closet, so you have to go to the linen closet to get like your sheets and towels and stuff like that. But I would recommend putting all your sheets and towels. I mean, before when I was using that as a major storage, I would put them in this bureau. But I think that this is a much better plan. you know, I think this is a much better plan. And so it's right there. I don't have to go to the other side of the house because my linen closet is on clear on the other side of the house. So that really completes this room tour, but I have another room tour.